Hello, I'm Dr. Lee. Welcome to the Practical Pain Management. In this video clip, I'm going to share Oedisch capsulitis and new intervention technique. Oedisch capsulitis is one of six common causes of shoulder pain. Frozen shoulder can be distinguished on physical examination by using the Cyriac method of MSK diagnosis. According to Cyriac method, adhesive capsulitis can be presumed by the passive motion test. The passive shoulder movement consists of external rotation, abduction, and internal rotation. When there is some limitation of a particular direction of passive movement, we differentiate into the capsular and non-capsular patterns. The capsular patterns begins with the restriction of external rotation, then abduction, and end with an internal rotation limitation. External rotation is more severely limited than abduction and internal rotation. There is a capsular limitation of the shoulder joint. Oedisch capsulitis is the most common pathology. Even we presumed frozen shoulder, and we don't know the area of the pathology. What are the common MRI pathology findings of Oedisch capsulitis? Edema and hyoscine intensity are found in many regions of anterior and inferior capsule. Selecting the coracohumeral ligament and inferior capsule as injection targets is logical in terms of pathology involvement. When there is edema and inflammation of particular structure, pain interventionists use steroids in the specific target area, so it is reasonable to select a target for the infected area. So choose the coracohumeral ligament and inferior capsule as targets. Previously, I showed a video about coracohumeral ligament. Please review the previous video. Now, I'm going to show MRI pathology of inferior capsule. Please use your imagination of a three-dimensional structure of the inferior anterior capsule. Coronal and sagittal T280 image with fat saturation image shows thickening and high signal intensity of inferior capsule. Sagittal, coronal, axial image. I can approach the inferior anterior capsule via anterior root. What is the technique of how I approach? I ask the patients on supine and externally rotate the arms as much as possible. My needle approach on the anterior deltoid region directly posteriorly. I will show the schematic illustration of the needle pathway. You may worry about brachial plexus injury, but it's quite far from it. After passing the skin and subcutaneous and muscle layer between the deltoid and coracobrachialis muscle, the needle penetrates the inferior aspect of subscapularis muscle. Magnified image shows the relationship between the humerus neck, axillary nerve, and subscapularis muscle. Now my needle is in the inferior capsule. Once again, magnified image shows the relationship to brachial plexus, axillary nerve, and humerus. With this injection technique, I confirmed successful contrast infiltration pattern into the inferior capsule, extracapsular structure, and interarticular space. Let's go to my operation room. Before holding the needle, I search the anatomic structure first. First target is the coracohumeral ligament. Thank you. My second target is the inferior capsule. My needle approaches from anterior inferior to superior posterior direction. Thank you for your attention.